Good morning, everyone. It's 9 o'clock. It's time for another Sulava webinar. Today, our topic is crisis communication using Microsoft Teams. And we are going to have a great 45 minutes ahead of us and you. Of course, feel free to ask me questions. I try to answer some of those questions during the webinar. And especially, but for the rest of the questions, I will answer at the end. It really depends on what kind of question there is and how, if I do spot them on my another screen, so I can stop and answer. But hey, let's get going. A few notes about Sulava. We were born in the cloud 2010. We have 120 employees and 6 MVPs. And yeah, you are going to get these materials afterwards, so you can read the rest of the details. But of course, it's a great place to work, and especially in these times, we are in a position where we can help lots of companies to tag along on this crisis as well. My name is Vesa Nopanen, call me Vesku. Feel free to connect me at LinkedIn, Twitter, follow my blog, etc. All you can contact me in email or in Teams as well, of course, if you have questions. So, if internal communication is not working properly, crisis can increase uncertainty, insecurity, and loneliness. Yeah, that's the thing. Why the internal communication is critical during this crisis. So, you have to think about how you communicate to people so you can kind of reach them out. How do you connect your work community together? Because you don't have the usual ways how to communicate. You can gather up everyone to the one place and then explain them why, what's the situation, and have a face-to-face contact or from eye to eye and see how they are reacting. And then you can kind of adjust your way how you do the communication. We don't have that right now, so we are relying on online communications a lot. So we have to consider what is the effective communication. And of course, why we need to communicate internally, especially during the crisis situation. People are confused. They don't know what's happening. So we need, you as an organization need to be able to give them some ideas. What's the big picture? What's happening? Where are we going? They need information. People need information even on the simple things. You need to have a channel how to communicate this to them. And of course, we all want to remain operational. We want to have business continuity. We have to build our communication so that we are in strengthening our business, but of course our community at work, and of course the rest of the networks. So figure out perhaps new ways where in a very quick way how we can increase the interactivity. Of course, the trust is important. Employees trust their employer, and of course the vice versa. Employees trust on us that we are the kind of core who are keeping the business up and running. So we need to be able to trust that everything is going to be okay, or if they are not okay, then okay, what's the information we need? So there has to be a trust that everything is communicated. And of course, the interaction, I mentioned that already, there has to be the interaction going on, even as if you are doing a virtual coffee moments, you are doing town halls, you are doing kind of a communication through Teams. Yeah, we need that communication all the time. It's now more important than ever. Today we have our trilogy in 4 or 5 parts, we have at least 4 main topics here, and I'm going to go through these different ways how you can use Teams in crisis communication. The first, of course, is the why the Teams is the best tool, and there's the one out of the box way how to use Teams there, and then I will go through different application enhanced models how you can bring in specific apps to Teams and build up your crisis communication using them. And I still have 40 minutes left. So why Teams? Teams number of users has been rising exponentially almost. It got 12 million new users when this crisis began, and everybody is doing online meetings. We are working online more than ever. Many organizations had Teams almost ready, or they were already starting doing the rollout, or if they were planning to do the rollout. And now Teams is really the hub for work for most office workers and lots of other people as well. So people are using Teams. That's one of the great things why, or one primary reasons why use Teams during the crisis. Why to use Teams to communicate information during the crisis? That's where people are. And when you bring this this information, when you bring the alerts, when you bring the notifications to Teams, people have the access to that information right away. For most of the information, you can get access through your mobile Teams as well. So it's a kind of a very easy way to reach out lots of people, as long as, of course, they are using Teams. But if they are working on projects, they are working on customer services, they are using Teams to communicate with the other employees, their co-workers, colleagues, networks, then alerts in Teams catch their attention. That's where the information is good to be. And of course, these times require teamwork more than ever. It's not the solo work. If we are working solo, we get sick. The risk is now a lot higher than it was a few weeks ago. Then the teamwork is even more important. Nothing should be based on one person right now. You have to create the teams. And of course, when you are using Teams to communicate about the crisis, you can get the two-way communication easily in there, because that's built in the tool. And it kind of encourages the teamwork. Share the information. Sharing is caring. And these solutions to Teams, they are really quick to deploy. It doesn't take weeks to get this up and running. It can be done in a matter of days, sometimes in a matter of hours. And the first solution I'm actually going to show is to use communication in organization-wide Teams. And yeah, you can start use it yesterday or 2 weeks ago or earlier right now. But this works especially well for organizations that are small or that are already using Teams actively. When you create an organizational-wide team and Teams, hopefully you have a kind of intranet team where everyone in your organization is. It can scale up to thousands, of course. The limit is the limit of members you have in the Teams, which is currently, I think it's 5,000 for these organized teams. And so for those teams, but if you now create one of those teams and start pushing the information there, you are not going to be able to reach out everyone. That's because you have to have the kind of practices how you use Teams. So those organizations who are already using Teams, you already have been communicating lots of your internal news announcements through Teams earlier, before this crisis, you're already using it. You have already kind of secured habits, how it's worked, secured habits, how you are going to do the communication. In that kind of organization, yeah, there's a built-in way to start creating communication about the crisis. The easy way to do it, which I'm going to demo, is just create a crisis channel or use your announcements channel, news channel, and make it a moderated one. So when the channel is moderated and you block out everybody from replying to that, okay, you may want them to reply or not. But the thing is that if you block the replies in this during the crisis, they can see the history easier. The messages kind of, if someone replies to the message that was done a week ago, it's going to be the first one they see. So it's not necessarily the correct information. That's why it's better to have everything kind of blocked and you only have the announcements there or the news, what the HR or the crisis communication crew is sending them. And then everybody can see the messages in the correct order. And you just enable the feedback channel on the other channels where you can have the discussion. So use links for those channels, for example. So let's take a look. And I have yet another demo environment, but I have this crisis announcement channel with some emojis there, so it kind of stands out. This is not perhaps the correct kind of the organizational wide theme, but I hope you get the idea. So we have one channel in a team where everybody should be, and we start creating a new post. It's easy. Instead of new conversation, we create a new announcement. And we start creating a new headline. I have some demo stuff ready. I can put the headline, I were traveling, work from home. Let's choose a background image. Because this is an announcement, we can use this fairly easily. Put the guy in there who's working in a very relaxed position. And put it there, we can add a subhead header, interesting subheader, and of course we can add some text. This is of course should be the text you want to communicate to your users. My demo text is just the stuff I grabbed from the Finnish official site. So then you have something you can communicate, and as you can see, everyone cannot reply. I'm going to show this is how it's done. And in case you have to, you know, you have several organizational units or something like that, you want to post the same information to, you can post it to multiple channels. Okay, now we have this. And if as another user would come in, they couldn't reply to that message because that was moderated. How to make things better and moderated? You go to the channel management and you go for the channel settings, and you have the channel moderation on. And on default, there's the team owners and the moderators, and who can start posts, only the moderators. And then you have the team member permissions. Do not allow reply to the to channel messages for members, and but keep the bots alive if you have bots that could write there also news, and perhaps some connectors as well. And the other way how the persons can get be better up to date about this is to use the channel notification. If there's a new post, they might want to have the banner and feed notification, perhaps to even to replies if a moderator replied to something, so they get the notification every time there's a new message or the channel is mentioned. Just checking on these, and you can stay up to date or way better than before. This works for some organizations. I had a video prepared for that in case there would be an issue. So first time in my life, I have a video backups of my demos today. All right, the next one, which is better for, especially for most of the organizations, is to bring in the centralized information. How do I act? What do I do? The previous one was about sending news bullets, putting them to the channel. But it is good to remember that not everyone is following the team channel. Even if you are a member of that org-wide team, people may hide the team, they may hide the channel, they may turn off the notifications, so they may not see what's in there. So that is not the most reliable way to communicate. But if you have a smaller organization and they want to follow that, they have used to follow the team, that channel earlier, then it can work. But for the Teams application, of course, install the application directly to Teams, and you can set it up so that it's going to appear in the left upper corner. That's going to catch attention. Put an interesting logo in that application and people will notice it. What's that? What's in there? We are using this ourselves. We have this this coronavirus information page. We are bringing that page directly to the Teams users in there. And when it's in the top left corner, it's very often the first page that opens when Teams is opening. It's not guaranteed that it's going to happen, but I have noticed it's opening it several times. Of course, you can have several tabs there. You can ask for information surveys. You can have forms. You can have kind of dashboards. The key thing is that all these pages, that content pages you create, they are updated in modern SharePoint. They're in SharePoint Online. They're easy to edit. So your company's content editors can go ahead and edit those pages and update the information without having to touch the application itself. And this is a very quick to deploy. And yeah, I said the content is easy to edit. And of course, the why, this is a one single place. This is kind of a one customer of mine said, this is kind of a crisis intranet. So you're bringing the most relevant pages, most relevant information to one place where they can find. And since there are SharePoint pages, you can view them on SharePoint. If you have a SharePoint intranet up and running, you can use the same pages there. You can put the links to the pages through the email if you have to. And so you can use them, read them even on SharePoint on SharePoint mobile app if you want to. So you can reach out this information very easily. That's the place where is the latest up-to-date information. And collecting data with forms. Of course, if you put the anonymous form in here, people can use that very easily. And for example, travel notifications, contact requests, hey, I need something to help. So you have a feedback channel. And that's using 10, you utilize Power Automate to do the processing. You can put them to the directly to one team, or you can put them to the list. You can kind of send an email to HR crisis team if you have to. Or you can further process that information by sending it in forward if you have a system for that. But that's just kind of one way, hey, here's the thing, this is how you can, for example, contact us. There's the question about the first part I had, can the moderator foster notifications to the members of the channel, telling about this, and the answer is no. You can put an at mention, I should have shown that. You can at mention the team, you can at mention the channel, but in case they have turned the channel notifications off, that's a personal setting, it won't go through. So you can't force that. So this is not the ideal way, but this works for some organizations. It's not the perfect solution for everyone. And but for, this was quite nicely timed question, is about, of course, we want to send alerts. We want to have a way how to keep people updated. So you can build, or we can build you a kind of a process that can used to be sending alerts, personal messages into Teams or email, or actually even SMS. Yeah, but that's extra cost and it's not cheap if you're doing that through Flow, but it's possible. So if you have a really need for that, yeah, it is lots of things is possible. And the user interface can be really simple. And if you have different groups of people you want to communicate to, you could do that. And of course, have different delivery messages for that, methods for that message. And of course, you can also or direct that message to selected Teams channels. So you can reach out a lot of channels in just one way, kind of one process. This is using Power Apps and Power Automate. Nothing too difficult there. And of course, you can publish information to all employees. You can, if you, for some reason, want to show this chart to everyone, yeah, then you can. But most likely, you have something more relevant information to be shown. This is just for demo purposes that you can embed things there. Of course, they can't require authentication there, so you have to consider what's the information you want to show to your employees in there. What is the really needed one? What's the critical one? This is most likely not the critical one. But let's take a look about our demo. And not this demo environment, this one. And I have the application here. So it's the big red button, as I heard it was called, or red lightning. And I can read the information from this one. And there's the not travel notification if I have to do it. And it's basically a good idea to have an FAQ. This I have nothing, it's a template page from SharePoint, but build up a FAQ how you can bring in the information to users. Add emergency contacts. People need contacts. They may have to call them. So they can collect the emergency contacts from here. You can perhaps bring up a kind of moderated world news page. This is just a SharePoint page. You can bring in some information here if you want to use in a different format. Or you can have, and what I usually like to say here is that you have instruction how we are working from home. What are our practices? Do we have a quick guide how to create Teams meetings, how to create, how do we communicate, which are our most important ways, how do we use Teams? And of course, providing information that, hey, here's the help. I may want to check out the help topics inside Teams. This is actually localized, so you can find a lot of information how to use Teams from this help, if in case you are wondering how to use the tool. And there was the tracker, but okay, this is the page. Yeah, and the contact request. People may want to be in contact. They may want to ask anonymous questions. So who should I, I can almost write today. I contact if I have corona. Yeah, somebody's worried. What should I do? They may or may not put their email address here. Let's do this anonymous way. And I can submit the request. So it's an easy way to put the request in. And because that also is based on flow, it may take a few minutes before it's actually up and running. So I go directly to the not calendar. Misclick there. Well, I have actually, it actually worked already. The crisis management channel has these requests. Okay, this is the flow users, don't worry about that. And this would include the email if that would have been given. And what should I do if I have corona? Now the crisis management team can think about, okay, people are asking about this. Perhaps this is something we need to emphasize more in our communication. How we, what should we do? And from here, they're usually the crisis central crisis management team or something like that could start sending the crisis alerts. I have the application here in Teams as well, but of course this is intended only for the crisis management team to be used. So who can send the alerts? And we can say, put here if you, okay, let's take that. If you have questions or put that message there, questions or corona, please contact our HR and medical authorities. Okay, that's not the best message, but let's do it for demo purposes. Select a group. We want this to be done to office workers and using Teams. And we can punch in the information. And then we just wait for a moment. But it's generally a good idea to have a team that have this crisis, everything about the crisis management in this one central team. What should they be doing? How do they communicate with each other? And there's always, of course, some other questions here as well. And since it usually takes for a moment or two now, the flow woke up and it's sending the message. Okay, what should I be doing? And I'm getting the card. And interesting. No, all right. It took a small lag and the question is there. And then so this reaches out everyone because it's sending a message directly to chat. People, and of course it's recommended that keep the notifications on for chat messages. And even if you don't have them on, you can see there's going to be chat messages in here. So you get a message from Flowbot and You can also deep link the application here if you want. So they can click on the button and they can see the latest information. So this is a kind of a very easy, cool way to create crisis communication in Teams. Okay, skip the video. And I have the next part, which is the company communicator. And this is a slightly different one from the previous. This is a kind of a, this is not only to crisis communication, this is a way to send managed communication to either to Teams or to number of users in Teams. And so the authors can ready the messages, they don't have to send them all at once. They can create drafts, they can co-edit them, so they can be a team of people who are doing those messages and do the edits until it's time for us to send the message. They can include a button, they can include a URL, so you can have one action included with that message. And then users can see the company communicator app. This is an application, this is a real bot. It runs on Azure. So they can see the better that, okay, there's something critical in that application. Okay, now I have something I should be reading. So they get new notification alerts through that application. And they send them the messages to users. And the big difference to Power Automate or Flow is that this is using Teams native APIs. This is using native APIs. So this is using Teams natively. This is very reliable. This is a lot faster than the Flow is for sending these messages. And of course, this is a excellent way to keep your employees up to date about latest news. This is the most reliable stuff there is. And let's take a look. All right. Just have to find my right location. I have a couple of messages. As you can see, there's a copy already about one message. I can create a duplicate of that message, or I could preview it or something. And the channel and do the other things, but I can now go ahead and edit the message. And it will open the message. This, I had a lot of test and webinar message. I just put it there so you can see it working. And I can start writing the message as I wish to test. This is a very plain text message. But I can have one image URL here, so I can have a picture and it looks quite okay. And I can put the author, anyone I like this. And then there's can be this one button, read the official info. And if I remove the official word, it's going to update the button already. And there's the URL. Of course, this would be about communicating what's important to your employees. This is not about what's happening in the public usually. But for example, when the travel restrictions hit in, it might be then you may have some changes happening, or if you have to keep your office empty for a week or 2 weeks, something like that, okay, don't come to the office at all, we all work from home, for example. Or now we can open the trainings or something like that. So they are up to date about what's the latest situation. And then you can send this message to the specific teams where this application is installed. I don't have that many teams because there are specific persons. Doesn't make sense either. I think it's about the chat to everyone because you want to reach out to everyone in the crisis. We can save it as a draft and it's there. So the other admin can come in and they can choose, okay, now it's time to send it, and I can hit send. I get the preview and it's going to tell who is going, who has the access to the app. It should be installed to everyone, and then we send it. And it runs in Azure and it's saying it's sending it, and I get the notification in here. As you can see, this is company communicator, and I get the one, there's something to be read in there. And it's duplicated in chat. So the same bot is actually in the chat and it has its own bot. But the message is not duplicated. It's just, you can read it from either place. So I can go ahead to the company communicator here, and I can see the message. Hopefully everything is loading a bit slow now. And it's saying this, I have this webinar message here. I get the picture, I get the message, and I could click on the information. It would open the Institute of Health and Welfare link, which I put there. And I can go ahead and see the history. Yeah, lots of few tests today. And if I go to the chat, I can also see that the company communicator, it's a chat there. It's a kind of a member I've been chatting with. The only exception is that I don't have any feedback channel, even if I can write something here, the bot is not reading it, so it's not going anywhere. This is a one way. But this is a very great way to create this communication. And what is great is after that, it's also showing, I have plenty of one user in this demo environment. So it's saying if there's successes or failures here, and when it started, when it was completed, how long it took. So this is a very excellent way to create communication. Okay. And finally, the crisis communication app. There's no questions. Strange. And there's still people online. Excellent. Thank you for all of you who have attended. It's great to see actually that many people. And the so-called, the real name is Crisis Communication App. This is a template from Microsoft. And I like to call it a kind of a crisis portal because this these names are very similar to each other, especially with the company communication, company communicator and the crisis communication app. So this is a kind of a crisis portal in when I'm talking about it. So this is a power platform based ready to deploy solution. It's going to bring in your crisis communication in one package to Teams or into Power Apps. And these admins of this crisis communication app can create those messages, update the information what's in here. This is also usually installed to one team, so you can manage that information from there. You don't have to enable all the world news, all the helpful tips, FAQs if you don't have them. And then the end users can use this view to use the crisis communicator as an app in Teams. Well, you can't get to this app in mobile. That's the current situation. So you have to be using Teams desktop to get to this information. It can also inform users through Teams messages, just like the second demo about the crisis alerts did. Or it can be selected to send emails or the Power Apps push notifications. So why do you use this? Your team needs to have everything in this all kind of one portal place. The biggest difference or big difference to the first Teams application that was in the top left corner here is that these news are only readable through this application. So everything is in that one portal. You can set the status as well. I'm going to show you a demo shortly. But the thing is that, you can find everything there, but it's just a slightly limited when you can use it. You have to be using it through Teams or Power Apps. But no more talk about, let's show information. And I will go for the admin side. Or do I have to use the demo, the recording? Let's see how fast is this today. So it's basically loading the Power Apps inside Teams. This is an application as well. Please load. And the administrators can do several different settings from here. Of course, who's the admin? Where's the logo? What's the group ID? We are sending all the information. What's the application URL? Is there an official RSS feed we are showing in Word News? And how do we deliver the information? We of course want to use Teams. And what features are enabled? So this is an easy admin control here. They can update the company contacts. Okay. and I can create a new contact, and it will be kind of grouped through the country. So I can create them, and if a contact is no longer relevant, I can go ahead and edit the existing one to make it deprecate. And the same for tips, links, FAQs, you can create them in this application. But of course, what we want to do is to send the company information, kind of to news. I have several news here, but let's create a new post. And wait it for to load. One thing I don't like is that this toolbar is very, very small, even if I have a zoom on. So it's a, now it's getting more required. Now you can start reading it. The blurb stuff in here is the short message that is going to be shown when we are sending the message to users. And the details part is the one we are showing showing when you are reading the whole message. So I can do some formatting here, and I shouldn't be destroying everything there. Well, if you have questions there, then I can put some, make it a heading, or let's put it that way, and then copy paste did its damage, so that's considered heading as well. Okay, you get the idea, and I can also create a link in here. And I have a link and I save the message. And this is also going through flow, and it's now working very nicely. And I'm getting the activity info as well. So I can see the title in here, there's the avoid traveling, work from home. And I can see the blurb text here. And if I click read more in a moment, it's going to open the Power Apps. So it's not going to be inside Teams anymore. It's going to open the either the Power Apps application or your browser, and you have to log in, and then you can read the news. Okay. But I also have this application for crisis communication here. And please load. And I can go ahead and access all this information. I can see the news. Now I'm going to back up from Zoom a bit. And I can see this latest news. Theoretically, I should be able to browse through the history, but most likely only the first 4 are relevant anyway. And here, so there's some slightly issues, but most likely they're going to be fixed soon, or you can start actually doing some fixes by yourself if you want. I can see the message here. And I can see the world news from the government RSS. This is from the way from the World Health Organization, so they are not that actively updating it. There could be some tips, there could be some FAQs, and so if you want to access this information, it's going to go and load them from the SharePoint lists where the information is stored. And I can open the FAQ part. And for the emergency contacts, there's also this kind of grouping through countries. So I could have several countries and I can see what's relevant. And making the request is also possible. And kind of could you create a summary message about what is critical now, and I can submit. I could have some request or personal request, and that request is going to land on the central crisis management team. Yeah. in here, and I can see that, okay, this would be the email, so I could contact and get the message in there. All right, so that's the tool. There's the question about, is this tool good for leaders of the company to share the latest information between them only? If you want to go what for the company leaders, you might want to do a group chat in Teams. You already know the audience. You already know which persons are receiving that. You don't have a kind of mass communication. But yeah, you could use the company communicator, for example, to send the information to selected persons. So you only select the leaders, or you select a team where they are, where every one of them are. So, and they agree that they will follow the team and get the messages there. So yeah, you can use these tools to share that information. The crisis communication app is perhaps not for that. It's for more like mass communication. But you could use the crisis alerts part to have one selection of, okay, this is only between the company leaders, for example. But you could do that with the group chat. You could do that with the team they are in as well. So there are possibilities to contact them. But if you talk about from the HR perspective, sending messages to leaders, then yeah, you could be, and you don't necessarily have the access to their team, you could be using the company communicator or crisis alerts for that. Crisis communication, could it be used for different countries with different languages? You can have one language, as with all. It's a power app based, so it could be edited to include several languages, and you could create that kind of messages there. But if you want to have a kind of tailored messages for different languages, then doing perhaps the crisis alert and making it have different kind of groups of people who are receiving the message, so they would be in different language groups. If you have AAD groups, you can say, okay, that's for the England, that's for Spain, that's for Italy, and then you send the message in their native language. Don't make it too complicated, don't require auto translation or something like that. This is a crisis situation. We have to find out the way, which is kind of a very easy way to create the communication, like kind of a quick and best solution. And of course, for the best practices, it kind of connects that here, is that do the transparent and quick on time communication. That's the key. Be quick. Don't wait. Don't wait for 2 weeks to get the app installed. Start doing the communication quickly. Get the app there, or get the way of communication there and start doing that. It doesn't have to be perfect. You can iterate it to be better over the weeks, but start doing it quickly so people can see what's happening. Don't enable everything. You don't have to install every tool there is, because that's a kind of a there's one question, I will come back to that soon. Enable on those, so don't install everything, because people will be confused. And have a team, a kind of central crisis communication team, not just one person, not just two persons, have a few persons team at least, depending on your size. So you have persons who are providing that communication. And make sure everyone knows the names and phone numbers of the emails of those persons, so who are responsible of the communication. And target messages, so not everyone is on Teams. Usually, if you have groups that are not in Teams, consider also how you put the message to them. Is it an email, or is it SMS? Is it something else? Just consider those as well. And let them know how to find the information. Make sure they know how to find it and keep that information up to date. And you have to consider that don't send too many messages. Don't overflow. That's very important here. How to get started? Teams application for crisis intranet is kind of what I would suggest. Have the crisis intra, have the information ready and displayed for everyone in your company, so they can see it. If they are Teams user, they can see it. If they are using only SharePoint links, they can see the information. That's critical. And it is very easy to update, so it's not an excuse of not updating pages included in that process. Then sending for alerts messages to users, sending alerts via Power Automate, for example, the crisis auto alert stuff I showed in the second demo, or to using the company communicator. You have to choose one. Don't do both. It doesn't really, it's not relevant. It's not ideal to have several channels. Just choose one and go with the channel unless you switch later totally to another way. And then there's a question about, can the company communicator or crisis app be used for large corporations? Teams 5,000 limit is not limited. No, it's not limiting. There are other limits, but they are basically, there's things you can do to overcome that. For example, crisis alerts, that 5,000 limits goes to the flow. How do you retrieve the information from an AAD group? But you can then use different groups. You can have different AAD groups with maximum 5,000 people, but then you think about sending the message in phases or having a different target groups that are sending the information. And for the crisis company communicator app, the bot can also reach out people over the 5,000 limit as well. The team limit or team member limit is not the key here. It's not the kind of limit how do you can communicate to people. As you can see, these were not in the team. This company info, for example, or however it's going to be named, is for everyone. It's not related to one team. The company communicator also sends messages to people's chat that is not in the team as well. It can be in a team, but for this crisis alert messages scenario, it should not be in a team only. So yeah, they can be used to overcome the limit. I'm already over my time. And of course, create a feedback channel to HR crisis team so people can contact them anonymously. So if they have questions, but they are worried for some reason about, they don't want to tell their name. And then somebody can answer them in kind of using the messaging or something like that. So everyone gets the same information. And all these are quick to deploy. It doesn't take weeks. It's a matter of hours to days. So, and of course we can help you. We can help you to get started. We can help you to get started with practices, how to kind of create this way to communicate the information to your employees. And of course we have online courses as well. If you need to know more about the Teams or Microsoft 365, everything, how to survive all this. So basically how to continue, keep your business up and running, how to kind of a remedy this situation so that you get the best out of that, or can at least you can go on. We have a couple of three-step offerings as well. If you don't have a Microsoft Teams environment, we have one offering for that scenario. And if you have a Microsoft Teams environment, but you need it to kind of boost it up and running more, then we have the other offering for that. So thank you. Please give me feedback. I welcome all the feedback, but that's the only way to learn. And of course, my next Teams Spotlight webinar is 2nd of June. There's going to be a huge number of stuff in Teams, at least it seems to be at this point, and there's already lots of new things that came out during the March. So of course, join the webinar as well, and please sign up. And be in touch, follow my Twitter, you will find latest information from there as well. Thank you. Hit in with questions. And if you don't want to ask questions in the webinar now, then feel free to send me email or contact me in Twitter or LinkedIn. You can choose the channel, I'm all there. Thank you for attending, and this will be recorded and shared on YouTube as well, so you can get access to this information later.